Hey Aaron, I have a big amount of tricks down, but hard flips are so difficult for me. Well, I don't think they called them hard flips because they were easy.
Yuck, yuck, yuck.
Good ollie, that kickflip was pretty much amazing. Good front side shove it. This is my foot position. You definitely want that front foot to be a lot more straight. Well, that was pretty interesting. You definitely got the flick there. You got the flick pretty good there. The thing that makes hard flips so hard is getting that front foot out of the way. A lot of these you're doing quite well at getting that front foot out of the way and keeping your front foot above the board for that matter. You're actually really close. Thanks for your time watching this. Hope you can help me with my hard flips. Cool. I also hope that I can help you with your hard flips. So let's see it in slow motion. Your front foot comes off, moves over, both feet above in the air, but not quite fully rotated, caught, and then put down. Let's check out this one. Your foot is definitely more straight there, and then you kick your toe off the side, which is good. The board comes around, under rotated, and then your feet come down, miss it. Okay, cool. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna practice stepping off with your back foot, popping it, scooping it with your, well, I mean, you kind of scoop it with both feet. So your front foot like kicks off to the side, but notice how like straight my foot is on the board. I think on some of them your foot was like that, and on some they weren't. But you wanna, yeah, kick that front foot off to the side, but definitely that's a step that I want you to do right there. Just leave your back foot off and just practice getting that flick. Now, the other part of that step is that you have to have your front foot there to catch it. So not only are you practicing the flick with your front foot and getting your front foot out of the way, but you're also practicing the catch. So don't worry about your back foot. Just leave your back foot on the ground for now and just practice over and over and over and over and over that pop, scoop, flick, catch with your front foot. And then once you have that really, really, really down, and it's just such a natural flick, and you're catching it in the air with your front foot the whole time, then you can go to putting your back foot on. Now, on a lot of them, your board was under rotating, so try a couple different positions on your front foot. Usually, just for regular kickflips, you'll be able to spin the board faster if you put less of your foot on. But I don't want you to put so much of the less of your foot on that you don't hit the board at all. You still have to catch it with your front foot on the toe, like I did there, and make it do that rotation. So don't take too much of it off. It might also be better for you if you put more of it on. I want you to experiment for yourself and see what works best for you. But yeah, once you get that good position, you just get it right in that pocket, boom! You got it, man. So the hard flip isn't actually covered in one of the Skateboarding Made Simple volumes yet. And I will emphasize that yet. So Skateboarding Made Simple Volume 5 will be coming out later this year, so watch out for that. But until you're ready for that, make sure you have all the tricks in 1 through 4 down so you're ready for that. So check out the videos, they're sick.